Hello everyone, it's your favorite name, Jen here. I'd like to wish each and every one of you a happy Holi / Phagwah. And I'm going to explain it since you guys know how I like to explain every holiday like Ramadan and Easter. Phagwah is also known as Holi, is an annual Hindu festival of color celebrating the arrival of spring. It is celebrated to mark the triumph of good over evil, good harvest, and fertility. The festival loosens the normal social restrictions by bringing people together not based on religion, status, and or age. The festival was brought to Guyana by East Indian foreparents who first came to Guyana some 183 years ago. Bye.
Thank you, Tim.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the channel.
It's your local family with Rita and Krishna.
I hope everyone is having a good day.
Thank you in advance for watching, and we hope that you enjoy this video.
Please subscribe to our channel
and share with everyone.
So a young lady was at a bus stop, right? She wore a very tight skirt, so she attempted to step up onto the bus, but she couldn't step up. So she figured, open the zipper in the back of his skirt a little bit, lower it. So he lowered it a little bit. He tried to go up again. He couldn't go up again, so he figured he'd lower him again. He tried, still not managed. For the third time now, when she tried, he feels two hands lift her up and put it up onto the bus. So when she turned around, she see a cowboy behind her. And he'd be like, sir, I didn't appreciate what you do. I didn't give you permission to lift me up. Why did you do that? The man said, I thought we were friends because for the third time, you keep lowering my zipper on my pants.
Hello guys, hello. How is everyone doing? Happy Sunday. We're here taking a trip to New York City, right? We're on the George Washington Bridge. We're hitting up a little traffic here, but we'll be okay. So this is the view off of the George Washington Bridge, right? Nice and sunny today, but it's still cold. You only look like that. Nice and bright, right?
Yeah.
So we got the whole posse with us here, taking a trip down to New York. A Sunday trip. We'll do some shopping, check out some nice restaurant, eat some nice food. What do you say?
Yeah.
All right, so big up to everybody. Happy Ramadan. Happy early Holi, happy Phagwah, happy Lent, right? So you know this time of the year, the people sell the meat and so cheap because everybody a fast. The Christian be on Lent and I eat meat, them only eat fish. Them Hindu about to fast, right? For Holi and Phagwah and so. And the Muslim only eat night time. So me are gonna go take advantage of all them cheap food. All right, so come along, let's go.
You don't fast for Holi and Phagwah.
Okay, I don't.
Tomorrow is Phagwah, guy. Happy Phagwah. And then we have, what do you call it? Navratri coming in, right, April 9th.
Oh, starting from then?
Yeah.
All right, so greens will go up. I stock up on a vegetable and so on now because it will be expensive and meat will be cheaper. So now you stock up on your vegetable and then you stock up on your meat. All right, guys, so this is the view off of the George Washington Bridge here. This is the best route for us today. Even though I have a little bit of traffic, it's still faster than the other route, right?
Check it out. We normally don't come on a Sunday to New York, but one of my friends went to Guyana and she brought back some stuff for me. So we're gonna go pick that up. I'm not gonna show that because she's not on social media. So I'm gonna respect her privacy.
So Kevin, we want to wish you a speedy recovery, right? Also your mom, Maria Bassett, and everyone in your family, and all of us here at your local family want to wish you a speedy recovery and may you feel better, right?
You live in Florida.
Kevin from Florida, right? We're all in your corner, hoping for the best for you and so you can have a speedy recovery. All the best, man.
And we got Jen here.
Hi.
Ethan.
Hi.
Jen ate already. Jen had roti and curry. And where's your lunch bag? Jen, where's the lunch bag?
Here.
And Jen have her lunch bag too. So Jen, we normally bring her food because she don't eat from anybody.
She's probably gonna get a light snack or something, but she have her. She's well prepared.
Yeah.
And ready to rock and roll.
What is this? A tunnel? It's so dark in here.
It's under the bridge. We're just getting off the George Washington Bridge, so it's a lot of highway around here. Under the apartment building, I believe. Yeah, the apartment is up there. We're going under the apartment building. This is under the apartment building on
across Bronx Expressway.
Yes, guys. I'm gonna have some 7 curry today, so stay tuned, stay tuned. I'm hoping to have it in the leaf.
Oh, the purine leaf?
Yeah, the purine leaf.
Yeah, that does make it taste a little bit better, right?
Yeah. With all the right. Hotness.
Alright, so if you need a purine leaf, you're gonna look for somebody who gets like a leaf or a banana leaf.
I don't know if it's cold. We should get it from Jersey. Those people, a few people have it in Jersey.
I think they cut it out, but I'm not sure if it's I don't think it died in the winter. Those are the ones that they don't bear banana or plantain. It's just a wild sucker leaf, right?
Yes, guys, this is the atmosphere. We don't like to come to New York on a Sunday. Sunday we normally relax, cut the kids' nail, sharpen up them pencil. What else? Make sure all the homework are done. Wash their hair.
Prep everything for back to school on Monday.
Yeah. But because I have to go collect because I don't want certain things to spoil. That's why. So that's why we don't, you know, we're making a quick trip unexpected. Let's see how it goes. Since we're here, I said let's go, you know, do some shopping.
Yeah, we're going to get some shopping in too. We're making it a trip, right? Not just for that.
Yeah.
Cover some stuff one time. Normally we come at least about every month or so, or once every 2 months. So while we're here, we're gonna cover that.
Yes, definitely.
We're here on the Trogs Neck Bridge. Since we're going to Jamaica Avenue, I think 200 and something street, right, for an Irish Azequiba restaurant. This is the best route here. So we come off the George Washington Bridge from New Jersey, and now we're here onto the Trogs Neck Bridge. This bridge is a nice bridge here. We got some nice view with the bay or the Long Island Sound.
Yeah, check it out. Amazing view.
Nice view. Get a good view of the city from here too. Maybe the camera is not gonna pick it up, but we can see it, right?
Yeah.
So today we're probably gonna reach within an hour, a little bit over an hour, which is pretty good. Normally we sit in traffic for about close to 2 hours, right, when we're coming. It's not bad, hopefully.
And Jen will be like, are we there yet? Are we there yet?
So hopefully we can get less traffic going back, because I know Sunday afternoon from my past experience going back to Jersey, it has taken like 3-4 hours. So hopefully we don't run into that today. All right, so you got some nice view over here. Some of them people get them boat and so set up. Hey, I gotta bring your boat to park over here too. And I want to land on the song.
Which one, a paper one or a plastic one?
Why are you letting out my secret? The real thing, the yacht, my yacht.
Yes, guys, check out the area here. Where is this, Krishna?
This is Hillside Avenue. We're on Hillside Avenue.
If you live around here, drop a comment down below. We never video this area.
I think this is Jamaica, I believe. I'm not sure. It's on Hillside Avenue. We're about to hit Jamaica Avenue now. So I think this is called Jamaica, this area, or Queens Village. I'm not sure if it's Queens Village.
If you guys know, drop a comment too. What happened, uncle?
The whole thing is Queens, man. Queens, New York. We're in Queens, New York. Where is it?
All here is Queens?
Yeah. But I think, you know, different section have different name. But it's still Queens, and if you're still not sure, it's New York.
Yeah, they have a lot of one family house here.
Hey, all them rich people live, man. All them rich guy needs to live this area.
Oh, really?
Yes. All them poor one live at Jersey. Them houses, you see them houses, they all them big. Each one of them houses about $750,000. So
you gotta get money, right?
I know, I'm just saying. They're small compared to the houses in Jersey, but they're more expensive. So you gotta be rich, right? To afford it?
I guess so.
Yes, family, so we're on Jamaica Avenue. We're about to hit the Narasha Essequibo restaurant, right? So we're gonna go check him out. We came out a while back when he first opened, and now we're gonna check him out for the second time.
We didn't get to eat there, only Ethan ate there.
Yeah, we got some stuff to go. Ethan got some stuff to go, but Ethan said it was good. So we'll find out for ourselves now. Hopefully we get a parking, right? That's just the problem around this area. parking. All right, so this is a hydrant.
There's a dollar store here. I gotta
go in there.
Park in the parking lot, man. I gotta buy something.
Okay.
What's there?
It's over there. So over there is the restaurant. We're gonna go hit him up in a second. Okay, look like we might get some parking on the other side.
Yes, fam. Check it out. Check it out. We here, right?
Yes, yes. Almost there. Not there yet. Almost there.
This is what the neighborhood look like here. They got some real nice house out here, though. I'm not gonna lie. You good, Ethan?
Yeah.
Okay.
They have an open house in a block away, so we're gonna go check it out. Seems to like the area, and you like the house, right?
I don't wanna live in New York, sorry.
Okay.
I only like come here to shop. Yes, fam, check out. This is the atmosphere out here.
On Jamaica Avenue.
Yeah, they got for rent and stuff. You interested? Looking for a house. So yes, we're here. Naris, Esequibo cuisine. Let's go check it out. They say happy, holy.
Look, Monday 3/24.
Look what they have. Naris, Esequibo cuisine, happy, holy. They got 7 curry, right? Dal, rice, bhaji, maigan, chana, potato, katahar, mango curry, pumpkin. Mango achar, sweet rice.
No meat will be served on Monday.
Puri, parsad, lots of sweets. Let's go. Yes, family, check them out. This is what the atmosphere look like in here. Yes, guys, check it out. What do you have here? Pachowni, they got pachowni.
Hello?
Oh, 7 curry. Check it out, guys. Most of the food run down. They run out of food, like, or they have it in the back. Check out the menu. And that's the owner. Let me see that. Oh, yeah, that's black one. That's Krishna one? That's Krishna one.
Chicken curry?
No, no. See that line there?
Oh man, they're never gonna get food today. Yes, guys, check it out. Check out the food. We should get the last of the food.
I mean, they're gonna make more. The last set outside.
Yeah, and too bad, Ethan
they ran out of food eating chicken curry. Ita wanted to try to eat the chicken curry, and it ran out. And if a lot of people, they ran out of katahar, what else? Katahar. What else?
I think that for now, and then chicken curry and stuff. I guess everybody is going for the seven curry, so they focus on that. They didn't focus on the other stuff. So let's dig in and see how this thing works then.
You're supposed to go in with your hand there, but apparently
it's too small. I don't have enough room.
Yeah.
Good, good. Feel like when I join you, how's your wedding? How's there, right?
Hmm?
Feel like when I join you, your wedding, yeah. Yeah.
Wait, what's you done with?
Oh, I got some solo. I got the coconut water for you.
So we have to go to a different restaurant for eating?
For eating, and then, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Are you checking out? Then, I think you have to buy a bottle of achar because...
You're bring your achar on this side? It's not enough for what you like, right?
Yeah.
Oh, they have option?
Mm-hmm. I don't know.
I think there's only one size.
I have everything except the pumpkin. I need pumpkin.
Mm-hmm. So you got seven?
And I never tried mango curry. Let me see how this goes. Here, first one for you guys. Cheers. How is it?
So so.
No. How would you rate it?
It's okay.
I'll give mine a 6.
Yeah.
I can't eat anymore.
Yeah, I'll agree with you. Maybe about a 6 or 7. No, probably a 6. You're right. With the price and everything that you pay for it, yeah, it's probably a 6. Yeah.
Is that about the price though?
Well, if you're paying for something, right, you gotta get that.
I'm not gonna give a review on it because you know me mouth nigga cover.
So what are we doing, Krishna? How is it? How is it? Okay, since you're outside, honest opinion, and you know we do honest review. Because a lot of people when we put it up, people come at the place and you know we don't wanna give wrong information.
Yeah, at the same time I want to support our Guyanese or Caribbean people too, right? I don't want to bash them and
exactly.
Bring their business down.
Yeah.
But come at your own risk, that's all I would say.
Yeah, come at your own risk. So we're going to look for some food for Ethan. And yourself?
Probably a snack. I mean, even though I didn't eat all of it, it's still heavy, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Mixed food or 7 curry is very heavy. And so I'll probably just accompany Ethan, maybe get an appetizer or something.
So let's see. Ethan, where
How
do
about you?
Go?
I think you didn't eat. So maybe you're going to eat something.
Yeah, I'll eat something.
All right. So we're going to pick a spot. We're going to decide on a spot. We got about maybe 20 or 25 minutes to get to Richmond Hill area, our favorite part of town.
Family, a lot of you guys tell us to go check out Bamboo Garden. But when I Google it and I check it, they say that it's temporary closed. So... the one on Atlantic Avenue, I don't know if there is any more around here. So if there is one, drop a comment, let me know, because I want to go check it out too. So we're just going to grab something light, do some shopping, and head back home because we already collect our stuff that we that came from Guyana. We don't want it to spoil. So let's go on this journey together. Okay, I just go home. I'm gonna come check out this club tonight. 305, Club 305. Oh, Club 305 is actually a grocery store. They get mango and stuff.
Alright, you go check it out tonight.
Hey, you got a big joke now.
Check out Dad's Deli, guy. Guyanese own fresh Caribbean food, hot and cold sandwich, snack and drinks.
Them guys, they got nice jerk chicken and stuff here.
Take risk and prosper, okay? That's what it says. Walk in arts, take risk and prosper. Yes guys, so we're approaching Liberty Avenue, Sibyl's area here. We're gonna go see, check out little Guyana there, man. See what's going on. Another part of Tong, right? While we're in New York, we like to come shop in this area here. Our favorite area to shop. So come on, let's go together. Where are we going, Rita?
We're gonna look for something for Ethan to eat. Ethan, you hungry, boy? Or are you gonna wait till you get home? I'm gonna eat? Okay.
I will get you something in a bit. So we're not going to Sybil's today. We're gonna try something different, right? Give a different take today.
Oh, right there, where the flag are. We going to Big Well or Big Well? Something, let me see.
I think it's Big Well.
Passion! Passion is the place to be! Look, 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 Guyanese! It's Big Well, yes. Is some parking? Oh, and you got sing right there, Krishna. You could get some doubles there. Because I know you look like you're hungry, man.
Don't be shy. Don't be shy.
Don't be shy. Liberty nicey today.
Liberty nicey. Weather is nice. The sun is bright. The sun is out shining bright.
We got a Mexican restaurant here.
Big Well. We're going to check out Big Well Bakery and Halal Restaurant. Oh, this is number two. Number one is over there next to
Halal. What is it? Dine-in? Courtside pickup? Okay, you could dine-in, Ethan. Let's see what they have. Yes, guys, check it out. We in Big Well. Check out the menu. This is what they have. Egg ball, cassava ball, pastries.
Oh, you guys. Okay. We'll also have a small cooked chicken pickup.
You're getting something for you guys?
Yeah. A nice sauce, yeah. Sausage?
No.
Look what they have here. Nut crush. Yeah, yeah. Sugar cake and fudge. Look, nut crush. Then when I was going to school, I used to love to eat that.
And we'll have a small chicken cooker.
Check out this sign they get, the guys. Family, check out the sign. Welcome to Big Well Bakery and Halal Restaurant. Oh. Hi Jen.
Hi.
You gonna eat something?
No.
You belly full?
Yeah.
Yes, Ethan. Ethan have right here. The Korean chicken curry.
Ethan had his favorite there.
Ethan hit the jackpot there. How is it, Ethan?
Good.
Hi, Krishna. Krishna, me talk to belly full, but what happened?
No, ma'am, I'm having a light snack. We'll try some chicken cook up there, cook up and chicken, however you want to call it, right? In Trinidad, they call it pilau, right? And I think they have another name for somewhere else, but anyway, bush cook, all in one, and stuff like that, right?
Yeah.
All right, so give it some nice pepper sauce there, and it looks good. This is good.
It's good?
Yeah. Very good, tasty. How's yours, Ethan?
Good.
And this is double trouble. Me eat mixed food and now cook up two very heavy food. When we done him, we never have a move. Me go sit on our way to retain the car.
You gotta walk it out, man.
You gotta walk it out? No, if you like, when you done eat this, you gotta go sleep. So, guess what? Me go sleep after this.
Okay, enjoy.
All
right, enjoy, guys.
So, I'm gonna share this with Rita, right? Don't think I'm gonna eat out.
Yeah, we're gonna share it. We bought all these stuff. But we got bread.
Black eye, pine tart.
Hey, look, you get out here. Salam, hey, me want cut my bangs.
Today's special, clear complexion tanala only. Eye, lip, and chin tanala. Mini facial 25. Yes, family, so we're finishing Big Well, not Bakewell, Big Well. And the drive continues. On Liberty Avenue on a Sunday?
They opened something here.
Are they opening something? Here. New, which one?
There's a mosque. Yeah.
Oh, that mosque, I think they renovated. It was always there. I think it was more behind. They moved it up front, if I remember correctly. I know it was an open spot and the mosque was behind. So either they make it bigger or they move it up front. I can't tell.
Oh, look, Kari, first today, hey, Krishna. Oh, I forgot. Sylvina tell me to try out the food here.
Oh, Kari Fest restaurant?
Kari Fest,
Uh-oh.
Next time.
Alright, the next rungs.
Next time when we come, you'll try it.
Oh, I thought it was in Rockaway Boulevard. That's why I said, okay. I mean, if I know it was right here, I'll probably check it out. But options are unlimited, right? On Liberty Avenue. So, one of these days, we'll check it out.
We'll check it out. She said the food is just like Guyana one.
Okay.
The fried rice.
Alright, so. We're gonna keep that in mind, so next time.
Oh, you got chair there too, if, let me see.
Oh, the dining?
Yeah.
So you have option, okay. And this is the Liberty Avenue, how it's looking today, right? Look like a little bit busy today. The sun is shining really bright, but it's still a little bit on the colder side. But not bad. With the sun, it doesn't feel too bad, right? But if you're in the shade, you're probably gonna feel it. A lot of people are out and about doing their shopping, doing their thing, just like us. I mean, not just like us. We're from Jersey. They're probably from around here. Or who knows? They probably come from Pennsylvania, Connecticut and stuff, right?
Yeah, upstate New York.
Yep.
Be careful, Uncle. What do you have here? Texas chicken burger. Jen, next time you're gonna come try this one out, right?
What?
You don't have to go all the way in Texas to try check Texas chicken burger.
You're not that busy today.
To me, it feel busy.
Really?
With all these cars. And this guy opened that, Anil's roti shop. They used to get some good jalebi. I'm sure they still have it. But I think it was under renovation or something, right?
Yeah.
There's a couple times we come in.
If you want the guy, not a Guyana, it's a Trini place, but they sell real good jalebi. It's like Guyana juice falling off. But since we're making our own now, so we stop coming.
And over here we have Little Guyana Bake Shop. Right across the street from Apna Bazaar too. And we're approaching Spice World. You guys can come check out Spice World, right? A lot of people have been asking us where we get the karahi from, or the pot that we're making all our curry and stuff. You guys want to get it?
This is a parking lot here, sorry, but...
No, this is a bus stop. So this is Spice World. This is where we get the karahi from. You want something here, Rita?
I want to go check for one karahi like a guy. No one. Remember me telling you?
I'm running here. I'm going to have to wait you here.
Let me get the famous Angie.
Check them out for your Indian wear there, right?
Wow, they got some nice ones. Anybody getting married this year? Let me know from early, okay?
So Rita can do her shopping.
Yeah. Coconut man there. This guy right across from Jade, he coconut that stays real nice.
Across from Tropical Jade?
Yeah.
You know they're out today?
Not like right across, I think.
So maybe right there, that's the same guy. That's the guy right there.
Oh.
Yeah, because we park and walk across. Yeah, that's him.
Okay. Oh, Krishna, we got by a beer and a brack.
Play Holi.
We got Good Hope restaurant here. Sandy Roti Shop, closed down. We got Sheriff Street. Lunch, their food is good too. Easy boy.
Welcome to Little Guyana. Thank you to all the parents who left Guyana and move across the globe to establish roots in the heart of Queens with nothing but a dream. Jen, your parents left Guyana with nothing but a dream.
Oh, come here, live here, and establish a life and have two beautiful kids. Handsome and beautiful.
We're here, I think this part they call Liberty. They renamed Liberty Avenue Little Guyana Avenue, right? From this section here, told you guys before in our previous video. So this section is under the train track area. We're gonna go do some shopping for our vegetables and some other supplies. We're gonna stop by Apna Bazaar and then we should be on our way home. Today is Sunday, so free parking, right? Maybe that's why a lot of people come out. They don't want to pay the meter. They take advantage of the free parking today.
You get Tropical Isle.
Tropical Isle restaurant, mm-hmm. Or Snacket. That's what they call it. They don't call it Snacket in the USA, right? In Guyana, they call it Snacket.
Dave West Indian here, guys. So if you love your Dave brand, the store is here. You could go get all your stuff. Right before you buy it on a second party and third party. I got Tropical G3 here.
This one is Roti Express. This one, I guess they sell roti. We never come to this specific location, but it seems like they have roti in this one. We always go to Tropical G2. We like that one. They have the good views and everything, but one of these days we'll check out the other location. But there's so many options here, right? And when we come, it's just one day. So we don't have time to check all of them out. You guys can tell us, right? If you've been to any of them, just drop a comment.
Which one is the best?
Let us know which one is the best, right? So you want to go get some stuff over here, Rita? In this Liberty fruit and apple juice?
This one or this one?
Okay, let's see. Look like we're going to struggle for parking. Seems like a lot of people double parked there already. Well, we'll see. We'll circle around and see if we get something.
At the bazaar, there's normally carry greens too, you know.
Okay. But I think these look more, to me, I think
enticing.
These are fresher and enticing.
More proper things.
Yeah, man.
Today busy? No parking on Liberty Avenue. We tried a cross street, same thing. Let's see what's trending at Chahat. I see a lot of green. You got rice bowl.
Yes, guys, so we're here at Matrix 2.0 to get some vegetable and stuff up in the bazaar and I get good parking. So we find a little something here. So let's see what they got. They got some nice edo. Baigan didn't look too good, but the rest of the stuff look nice here. Nice squash and so. We got lime, mango. Look, mango. Riri pepper, look. $14.99 a pound. You guys check it out there, right? Now let me get riri pepper. Riri pepper right here on Liberty Avenue.
We got some nice bowl right here. You can park it? Park on a hydrant. Next to a hydrant.
What do we got? Fresh mango, cut up mango from Guyana.
Yes, I love cut the heart.
Oh, we got a nice steam cut the heart. No, pre-cooked cut the heart. And you got the steam.
You gotta cook it back though, eh?
And you got the steam money to make yours.
You gotta
make
cook
it from
that one.
Squash.
Yeah. I look mango curry.
Curry mango?
Mm-hmm.
Cut curry mango.
It's a trendy thing, so you gotta say curry mango.
Or mango curry. No, that's right. Whatever.
Yeah.
Let's check out this store. What they got here? We got nice achar, pepper sauce. Check out all the supplies here. We got nice fish here. We got nice snapper.
you getting ready to come?
Banga, Mary. Fine banga, Guyana. You farm like this, you throw the rice on it by yourself.
Uh-huh.
I check out all your seasoning here. We got tamarind chunks. What else? Check it out, family. Get some nice cane here.
Check it out, fam. We finished shopping. Krishna?
Yes?
What happened? You didn't go to Apna Bazaar?
Apna Bazaar, no, we didn't depart, but we got everything that we wanted from Apna Bazaar. We have it right here at Matrix 2.0, right?
Yeah, guys, support them. They sell wholesale.
They sell wholesale to the public. And if you call me in retailing, they probably give you free plastic bag.
Yeah. Free plastic bag, free soda.
And if you buy anything over $35, they give you free bread or pastries, right? So please check them out.
Yeah, she hook up us up. Give us the thing for give the kids.
She give us all this here. The stuff that we buy. Free tennis rules. Free buns. Free pastries.
They and also, two soda for the kids.
They also give us soda for the kids there. See? Check it out.
Yeah.
Solo soda. Two cream soda there. So, thank you guys.
And look. I think this big flower here is 5 rolls. How much for it, Krishna? How much for it?
Give it to $14.99, it's special. $14.95.
Yeah. And she gives me this mango curry mango.
Try it out. I'm gonna try that. We're gonna make some nice mango curry. We'll let you guys know how it comes.
No, it cooked already. Just gonna warm it up. Yeah.
Oh, that is like the Kandahar. It's pretty
cooked. No.
No,
it's
okay.
Cooked.
All right, good.
Yes, fam. So we're gonna head home now.
All right, so. We'll see you guys on the drive home. We'll show you guys the drive to on the way, the Sunday traffic. So come on, let's go. So we finish our shopping and we're on our way back home. We're gonna go through the Bronx again. We're gonna go through Grand Central Parkway towards Triborough Bridge, right? We're here on the Grand Central Parkway. We're gonna see if we're gonna pass by LaGuardia Airport, the number one rated airport in the world.
Really?
Or in the US, I'm not sure, but I know it got high ranking compared to a few years back when it was rated the worst. But they spent a lot of money, upgraded. Now it's one of the best. We're here next to City Field.
What's going on there, though?
That's where the Mets play baseball. So baseball season is about to start in a week, I think. So Mets play over there. Let's see if we pass through next to Yankee Stadium, too, if we go that route. Are we gonna go through Manhattan? I think we're gonna go through Randall Island through Manhattan, so we might miss that. But LaGuardia Airport is coming up. Looks nice and sunny outside, right? It doesn't feel too bad anyway, even though the temperature says 48 today. It doesn't feel like 48, right?
No, we had to take. Oh man, Krishna, your yacht over there. Your dream, your yacht in your dream.
See, we wrap them up nice and get in there, right?
Yeah. You wrap them in your dream too? Wow, traffic like... We should reach home around 4:30 and stuff.
Yeah, within an hour. Even though we hit a little bit of snag here, but we should be okay. I think if we go through Manhattan, directly through Manhattan, through Holland Tunnel, it'll be... I was checking it, it was going to be like 40 minutes more.
What if you can rent them yacht? This it look like, right?
I'm sure it was a rental, but a lot of people are probably not going out now. They probably use it mostly in the summer.
Wow, nice.
That's right behind LaGuardia Airport, or in front, depends on what angle you're looking at it.
And I'm really, really excited about my shopping today.
Yeah.
I got some nice fresh fish. I normally don't like to buy fish in New York because I think in Jersey we get fresher fish there. But today I got some nice one. Oh, look at the plane. Landing, Jen. I don't know if you could see from here.
Yeah, she missed it. Yes, guys, so check out LaGuardia. This is the multi-million dollar upgrade that they did. I know it's now it's ranked very high. I'm not sure what is the exact ranking, I think. But for this, around this area, hey, this is the number one. I'm not sure in the country. Might be number one too, but I'm not sure if it's number one in the world. But one terminal, they say, was the best. Or among the best. All right, so LaGuardia Airport. When me get me green card, me go book me flight and fly out from here.
What do you mean you don't have a green card?
Me illegal alien. So one of these days when me get me green card, me book me flight out of here. So we can check it out.
Wow, real nice, guys. Check it out. We have a flight from here?
No, we never flew out from here.
We never fly out from LaGuardia.
Newark, JFK, Philly. Yeah, those three we use for when we fly from around here.
Let me see if I can zoom in. I can't zoom in to this, right?
No. But that's what the people who rank airports say, right? Not just me. The people who rank them airport, they said this one ranked very high. Yes, he says, welcome to the world-class, award-winning LaGuardia.
Wow. Nice.
So I guess they win an award too. So we come through the branch. We decide to come through the branch. Manhattan side have a little bit more traffic. So we're going to show you guys some more landmark here. Yankee Stadium, I'm not sure if we can see it from the car here or off the highway. But I know it's behind this building here. The Yankee Stadium, that's where the Yankees play baseball. So probably this is a mall or a parking area. Yeah, this is a mall.
Yeah.
But the stadium, let's see if we can get a look right behind here. Yeah, right there. Yankee Stadium, that wrong building there.
Come buy me something at the mall.
It looks small, but it's very huge, right? To actually go inside.
You can. Look over there, Yankee Stadium.
He turned into basketball, it's not into baseball. Yes, guys, so we're back on the George Washington Bridge. We're heading back home. This is the best route, like I was saying earlier, for us right now with the traffic and stuff. It's not bad. We extended about 15 minutes more. But it's still not bad. I think if we had gone through the Holland Tunnel, we probably would have taken longer. This one you gotta pay an extra toll, but I don't mind paying the extra toll as long as we're moving, right? So Rita, you enjoy your shopping, y'all, in New York?
Yeah.
You got everything that you need?
Yes. I got everything I needed more when I was in Guyana, right? Mm-hmm. When I was small in Guyana, I always wanted to come on this bridge.
All right, so here you are. You realize your dream, your girlhood dream.
And now I'm on it.
So you want to share the experience with her?
Yes.
I don't think you can see the river. It's probably because we're moving, or you can see it a little bit.
A little bit.
So that's the Hudson River coming down from upstate New York, leading into the Atlantic.
Beautiful view.
Yeah, we pass New York. We into the Jersey half of things here. So welcome back to New Jersey. This is what it looked like on the BARDA crossing. Make sure I get my passport ready. We're gonna have to declare. I got anything to declare to immigration?
Yes.
From New York to New Jersey?
We got some bora, bachi, bygan, fish. You gotta declare all that, you know, you get fine.
Yeah, right. So we're gonna declare all that. No liquor and cigar?
No, we didn't have no liquor today. Because we went to Nourish. Sell anything, and then we went to a halal place.
Obviously they're not gonna sell.
Yeah, it's okay. You don't have to have wine and beer all the time, right?
Alright, so
beer that's in mind.
The checkpoint is on that side. Oh, I guess we're not checking in going from New York to New Jersey. They check from Jersey into New York. So we got lucky. Welcome to New Jersey, guys. Welcome to New Jersey. So this is the look of the Jersey side of things here from New York.
Oh man, you know what I forget? I was gonna buy the lottery ticket in New York. I got the Jersey lottery ticket. Right now, I think the Mega Million is over 1 billion, and the Powerball is close to a billion. I think 800,000 or something. 800 million, sorry.
If you win the lottery, what are you gonna do with it?
Not decided yet, but I'm sure it's gonna be whatever you decide.
Homeschool.
Homeschool? You're gonna go back to school?
No, the kids.
Oh, kids gonna be homeschool. Okay.
I'm gonna be rich. I don't need to go back to school.
Hey, you're never too old to learn, right?
True.
And that will be your chance, right? You're rich, you got everything. But anyway, I forget to buy the ticket, so hopefully I win the New Jersey one. You guys wish me luck. Okay? If we won, all of us gonna go on a cruise together.
Yeah.
We're gonna go on a cruise around the world. What is it?
Of course. Are we gonna pay for the kids to homeschool too?
Exactly. So they're gonna, Ethan and Jenna are gonna have company. Alright, let's stop the dreaming. Back to reality. Work in school tomorrow.
Yeah.
Regular life, right?
Yeah.
Alright guys, so I think we should have a smooth sailing from here. We'll be home in about 25 minutes from here. From the George Washington Bridge, as soon as we get out. It's about 25 minutes.
Yes, fam. So we came home from New York pretty early because it's 5:45. We finish. I chip out all my greens. It's not me by myself, you know. It's teamwork. I chip out all the greens, pack out all my grocery, put what I have to go in the freezer, and let me show you what we got. We got some nice pepper here, which I'm not gonna use because I'm the boss at making my own pepper. Look, I got a nice jerk chicken fried rice.
Let's see.
It's real hot. Let me open it. I buy this for Ethan for dinner. Check it out.
Real nice.
Proper things. And guys, I know tomorrow is Phagwah. Please don't come for me because I bathe and pray every day, but I'm not like a religious person. I celebrate all the holidays. For Navratri, we normally fast then. But for Phagwah and Holi, we normally celebrate. I see that's what the Indian does, right, Krishna?
Yeah.
It's time to celebrate. Okay, so I have this one for Ethan. We have these for me and Krishna. Original.
It's okay, you don't have to open, yeah.
You know, it's hard to, yeah. Original Haksa Halal. Check it out. Proper things. I bought two.
With the color. With the chicken with the color, right? The reddish color.
Mm-hmm. And it's hot. I said I was going to put it in the fridge. I'm not going to put it because it might sweat, right?
Yeah. It's still warm. Because I had a cooler too that I take over there. So I put it in there and it stays there.
Yes, fam. I didn't show when we get this there, but we also get some dal puri here. Let me show you guys. Proper things, I ain't bad, I mean, no.
The dal puri look like he sweat up, and top one look like he sweat up
the
day.
The top one.
Yeah.
Let me see what the size, because we normally pay $2.50 for the dal puri. Today they charge $3. And this dal puri is from Haksa Halal, right? So let me see. Oh, snap, you right for big?
Can I make it bigger?
They're right to raise it. It's
they increased
huge.
It? Oh, yeah. They never make it this big. I never see it this big.
Oh, what do you?
No. I think that's because this one sweat a little bit. So maybe the first couple on top is probably going to be like that. Because
okay, so let me put this on
so
the side.
What we should have done is probably pop a little hole in the file wrap. But it's okay. We can use those out first.
Oh, my God. Krishna, I think that's why they raise it. They make it huge. No.
Yeah, and I remember when we first started going there, a dalpur used to be a dollar, right?
$1.50.
No, a dollar. And then eventually they raised to $1.50, then $2, and then it jumped to $2.50 or it jumped direct to $3 after that?
No, $2.50.
Okay. $2.50. All right, so they take it up slowly.
So what I normally do, right, because Jenna, she loved the dalpuri from there, but I think I think I got a new dalpuri lady there. I think this dalpuri is different because it look like a trini. People cook them trini dal puri. So what I normally do, right, family, because once you order more than 10 dal puri, they don't wrap it. So this is started out for me here. What I do, I put it in this wrap like that, right? And then I wrap it up like this.
Oh, so I have a hack for that. If you're gonna order 30 dal puri next time, tell them you want 10 dal puri, but freeze it, so they can wrap it.
I know. I got it for 3 different people, right?
Exactly. So tell them you want 10 dal puri, separate, make it separate order.
Yeah, smart move.
Yeah. So next rounds we're gonna try that and see. So you don't have to come home and wrap. But anyway, Rita like to wrap it. Hurry. Even if the people wrap it, I think still Rita is going to come home and wrap it again.
Yeah, because what I do, I put it in the freezer, right?
So you want to wrap it up good so you don't have freezer burn and stuff like that.
Yeah, you don't want to get freezer burn.
And then when you do it like this and you put it in the freezer, when you take it out, right, and you're ready to eat it, it stays the same way. So I have another idea too. Mm-hmm. We buy a whole bunch of flour, right? Uh-huh. From a matrix 2.0, 25 pound. Why don't we make our own dal puri?
No, I told you that we're gonna start making ours because it's too expensive.
All right.
We pay $90 for 30 dal puri.
Man, that me whole day pay and a half day.
I know, right? I like this dal puri. So far that I ordered dal puri from them, I think this is the best.
Yeah, and we're not crying, but it's definitely worth it. We're just joking, right? But I mean, inflation is there for real, and we used to pay cheaper back then, but definitely it's worth it. And for Jen, we're going to spend the money anyway, right?
Yeah. No, guys, when we're talking about price, we joke about it, because if we didn't want it, we don't have to buy it, right? But
the people are not forcing you.
Yeah, they're not
They have it, you go there, your choice, if you want to buy it or not. But at the same time, it's reality too, right?
Yeah. We're sharing it with you guys because then you guys gonna message me and ask me or call me. So I make my job easy.
All right, so I'm gonna get going.
I wanna open one.
Okay, well, open one and see the full size.
But they're all so thin.
No, I think from the as long as you start getting into the bottom here.
This one, they all have like a hole on it.
Okay.
But it's okay.
Well, it's that time of the year again. Where we celebrate Phagwah. Happy Holika, everybody. New way. Phagwah is here. We must all come together. Holi kereda guvida.